In this episode of Gourmet On The Road, we are going to taste a hearty North Karnataka meal. So stay tuned till the very end.
Depending on how spicy you like to devour your North Karnataka meal, you can mix and match these along with your Jolada Rotti and the other vegetables that you have on your leaf.
Whilst I've explored many a local cuisine in and around Karnataka, the one cuisine that I haven't tasted too much of is North Karnataka food. Well, it's time to make amends, and I'm here in the western suburb of Rajajinagar in Nama, Bengaluru, to visit an establishment that's famous for its North Karnataka fare. We are here at Hotel Nalapaka, that's been around for the last 20 years and is famous for its Jolada Rotti meals, the Davanagere Benne Dosa and the Girmit, amongst other North Karnataka delicacies. So let's go and taste some North Karnataka Uta here at Hotel Nalapaka. Let's go. There's some food going out in large quantities, always a good sign. And this is another good sign here. There's a board which talks about the benefits of jowar roti meals. It says it's a perfectly balanced meal containing more protein, fiber, herbs and vitamins and less carbs, fat and oil, sugar and calories. Exactly the sort of thing that your doctor would want to hear. So let's go in and check this out. You have the menu right here. We've arrived at 12:30, it's lunchtime, so we're of course going to taste the jowar roti meals or the jolada roti meals. But I'm also hoping to score some of these snacks that they have here. And I'm told popular here is a girmit, the mirchi bajji that goes with that, and also the Davanagere Benne Dosa. Let's see if we can taste some of those dishes along with our jolada roti meals. The restaurant's barely open. And there's already a steady hum of visitors here. Speaks for the popularity of the place. We're going to find a seat at the table, but before that, let's go into the kitchen and see what's cooking. Namaskara. So I'm here with Mrs. Kavitha Lingayya and Mr. Lingayya. So this restaurant new start maadidru. ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ ಹಿಂದೆ
20 ವರ್ಷ
ಇಪ್ಪತ್ತು ವರ್ಷ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಈ ತರ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ ಇತ್ತ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ ಶೆಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಬರೀ ರೊಟ್ಟಿ ಪಲ್ಯ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆಫೀಸಿಗೆ ಊಟ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ದ ಊಟ ಎಲ್ಲ 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮುಗಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಟ್ಲು ಮಾಡಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಹೋಟ್ಲ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ
ಸೊ ಶಿ ಹೇಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಹುಬ್ಳಿ ಬಾಗಲ್ಕೋಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶಿ ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಓಪನ್ ಅ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ to share the food that she grew up with. And it began first as a catering business. So slowly, slowly it grew into this restaurant. Iga ellarige kelidre North Karnataka food andre Nalapakkege barbeku. Yaake aa tara ishtu popular agide?
Uttara Karnataka de special agi alli idene item idiyo adella nammalli ready maadu.
Okay.
Ade jana ella ishta padtaru.
So she says that also a lot of the ingredients that go into the dishes here come from Hubli, from Davanagere. So whether it's the brinjal, whether it's some of the masalas that go into it, etc. So idli special enide nanu
special biranji
anta today Thursday biranji rice special
biranji rice andre
special meals
rani bennur
ha rani bennur
in biranji andre eno biryani tara
biranji rice benne alle madidare
andre biranji rice adu names of the biryani ge similar ala
yeah yeah
so idu North Karnataka the biryani ya vegetable biryani
rani bennur
spicy ide andre I can smell the cloves ಕ್ಲೋವ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಘಮ ಘಮ ಪರಿಮಳ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಮಡಕೆ ಕಾಳು ಬದನೆಕಾಯಿ ಎಣ್ಗಾಯಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಹಸಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪೈಸಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ದಾಲ್ ಯಾವ ದಾಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಗರಿಬೇಳೆ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ಮೂಲಂಗಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಲಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ That is a famous North Karnataka girmit mirchi bajji. That's the bajji menzin kai. I love the way he is dipping the chili into the batter in a manner that you still have the chili exposed. You've got the casing, you've got the batter covering that chili, but you still have part of the chili exposed. So you're seeing that bright spicy green of that chili. I was going to taste this on the table, but this looks so delicious that I can't wait to taste this. Davanagere Benne Dosa. So Davanagere Benne Dosa, yake ishtu craze ide janarige?
Adu taste agirutte.
Taste agirutte.
Mamuli dosa tara irutte.
Ha.
Tumba taste agirutte.
Andre adu hittu nalli irutte eno?
Adu hittu bere. Masala dosa ge bere.
Ha.
Idu Benne Dosa
ge bere.
So there is that Davanagere Benne Dosa, that white butter that goes into it. So that is that butter which makes for that delicious Davanagere Benne Dosa. Benne means butter. And I'm told that the butter that goes into it, the white butter, is the purest form of butter that comes from the villages. There's nothing else that goes into that butter. It's the pure goodness of milk that's transformed into that delicious butter that makes for that delicious Davanagere Benne Dosa. This is the Girmit. So you know the Girmit? Lali.
Onion,
onion
or
ogane, palya
madi,
adikke kalisu.
Turmeric
Girmit and the mensin kai bajji. Yaki adara combination?
Mirchi.
Uttar Karnataka dalli
ishta. Uttar Karnataka.
Atara combination.
Regular famous.
So what's interesting about the Girmit, although it may look like a dry bhel puri, but it isn't. Of course. Mensin kai. There's also some gram flour that's gone into it, so it gives it a nice grainy sort of a bite. So this is not your typical bhelpuri. For those who say Girmit is the bhelpuri of North Karnataka, no, this is something entirely different. The flavors are different, the textures are very different, and I think that onion ogarne, or that burnt onion that goes into that ogarne, gives it a nice savory bite. And the combination with this is the chili. So this chili you fry it. Wow, so this is a holige, but it's made with groundnut. So the shenga holige. And of course, this is a paddu, which is made with a dosa batter. And of course, with the potato and the chutney, this is karanjikai.
Karjikai.
Karji kai.
It's puran poli.
There's a lot of food to be tasted, and we're going to taste some of that on the table. But before that, I want to see how that Jolada Rotti hege martira. Adnodaboda. Let's go and watch that Jolada Rotti being made. This is such a happy sight here in the kitchen of Hotel Nalapaka. You've got the women folk of North Karnataka who are preparing their food, which is the Jolada Rotti meal. The air is filled with the song that they're singing, the folk song. I haven't tasted the meal yet. I haven't tasted the Jolada Rotti yet. But just taking in this atmosphere, I'm already getting a sense of the flavor of their land. So that is Kavitha's parents right there. And apparently, they are the ones who help her procure all the ingredients. Because that's so important. If you really want to prepare food with the flavor of a region, it's important that the ingredients come from the region and the hands that make the food also come from the region. Because that truly gives it a flavor of the land. So apparently, they bring the jowar from Hubli and then they grind it to their specifications before it's being used here. So sesame seeds. So this is a Jolada Rotti, and apparently on a Thursday they also put the black sesame seeds in it. This is Biranji otike combination. Andre idro otike Biranji tintare. Palya adalla. That kitchen tour has certainly whetted my appetite. So of course, we are here to taste the Jolada Rotti meals, but I want to also taste some of those North Karnataka snacks. Namely, the Girmit along with that Mirchi Bajji
and the Davanagere Benne Dosa. So we will taste that before we taste our Jolada Rotti meals here at Hotel Nalapaka. I think as I wait for my snacks to come, I've got some buttermilk here. I think just the perfect lining that you need for your stomach in preparation of a hot spicy meal. There's plenty of chilies being used in the kitchen here, so I'm bracing myself for a spicy North Karnataka style meal. So I thought we should make a start with the three top selling snacks here at Hotel Nalapaka. So I've got the Girmit, Davanagere Benne Dosa and the Bajji, the Mirchi Bajji. I'm going to make a beginning with the Benne Masala Dosa. I've already broken into the dosa, but if you look at the dosa, it's got that perfect, lacy, crisp texture. I'm going to taste the dosa first just by itself. I can already taste the butter on my fingers, all that white butter that's gone into this dosa. You can hear the dosa go crunch, crunch, crunch. It's perfectly crispened yet soft on the inside. And you taste the lush butter. My fingers are drenched in that white, pure butter that they source from villages. Because they say that's where they get the purest butter, because that's where you get the purest milk. And of course, you've got the chutney and the palya, but you can taste this dosa just by itself. I'm going to taste it now with some of that coconut chutney. That dosa with that chutney nearly melts in your mouth. Take some of that palya with the dosa. What's interesting here in the Davanagere style dosa is the fact that there is no turmeric that's used. So the color of the potato is white. So it's got some potatoes, it's got some onions and perhaps some chili somewhere in there. I think I prefer the dosa just by itself. Perhaps with a bit of the chutney for that perfect bite. Time to taste some of the Girmit now. So the Girmit is basically the puffed rice. The turmeric stained puffed rice. You've got some shave, you've got plenty of onions. They love their raw onions here in North Karnataka. They've also got some curry leaf here. And that ogarne or the seasoning of onion. You can taste the savoury kick of the onions and the earthiness of the powdered gram flour that's gone into this girmit. So what I'm told here is that the combination to the girmit is this fried chilli. So in North Karnataka, they love their food spicy. So chilli is a must in every dish, in almost every dish. And if the dish doesn't have too much chilli inside the dish, then you've got a chilli that's served along with it. Just so that you don't miss the chilli. That's typical North Karnataka fare for you. I think I just bit the tip of the chilli, so there's not too much chilli seeds in there, so it's not so spicy, but you can definitely taste the pulp. That spicy pulp of the chilli. I think I'm going to go for a bite of the Girmit and then chase it very quickly with another bite of the chilli. You can definitely feel the spice, but it's not overwhelming. It's not spice that will obliterate your taste buds. And I think the chilli perks up the flavors of this Girmit. And the other chilli that you apparently try with the Girmit is the chilli bajji. I love the way they fry the chilli bajji here. You've got a thick batter that's encasing the chilli, but it leaves enough of the chilli to be seen. Strangely enough, you taste more of the spice in this green chilli, despite it being encased in that thick gram flour batter. I think what really happens here is that the gram flour batter is minimally seasoned and the chilli in sharp contrast makes its assertiveness felt even more relative to that gram flour. So you're tasting the spicy kick of that green chilli a lot more as opposed to when I tasted the green chilli with the Girmit. But it makes for a tasty bite. I'm told this is one of North Karnataka's most popular street food and I can understand why. With some chutney now. That chutney has some mint in it. It just perks up the flavors. I think I'm going to chase down my mirchi bajji with a spoonful of the Girmit. I want to dissipate that chili heat of the chili on my palate.
A great meal always begins with a banana leaf.
So I have my Jolada Rotti meals here. This is the Jolada Rotti, the roti that's made with jowar or sorghum flour. And of course, don't miss that generous dollop of butter that goes on top of it. Butter makes everything taste better. And then, of course, you have the salad, you got the cucumber, you got some sauteed chilies, plenty of onions. And then this is a speciality here. This is the vegetable, this is the enegai, which is made with eggplant. And this is a combination with the Jolada Rotti. Then you have a thick lentil preparation, which is made with a tuvar dal. And then you have the sprouted mung beans. That's also called madike kalu here. And then you have the chutney here. This is a chutney that's made with the gram flour. And then you have some dessert. This is a kadle bele paisa. You have some raita and the curd. And this, I'm told, is a speciality from the Rani Bennur district in North Karnataka, and this is the Biranji. This is served here at Hotel Nalapaka only on a Thursday. So we are here on Thursday, so we are lucky to taste that. These are supposed to be a classical combination with the Jolada Rotti as well. So this is a Gural chutney. This I am told is some sort of a seed, perhaps the Niger seed. And then this is another chutney, and this is made with the peanut, the shenga, as they call it here in North Karnataka. And this is the Puttani chutney, which is made with gram flour. So I want to taste that Jolada Rotti just with that butter first. I love the nuttiness of that Jolada Rotti. And then butter just makes it taste so delicious. We're going to next taste it with the enegai, the eggplant. This is a speciality of that region. There's a fair bit of lemon that goes into it. You taste a creamy bite of the badne kai. I'm not a big fan of the eggplant, but this is delicious. The eggplant is soft. It soaked up all that masala. You know, I was expecting this to be very spicy, but it's quite mellow actually in its flavors and makes for a delicious accompaniment to that Jolada Rotti with some butter. I think next I'm going to taste this Gural chutney. Never tasted this before. And also some peanut chutney, some shenga chutney. Get some butter on your Jolada Rotti. And then take some of that powder. So you got the Jolada Rotti, you got the Gural chutney and that butter. You know, that has a certain spicy sweetness. You can taste the chili in that because that's beginning to warm the throat, but it's not as spicy as it looks. I love this combination. I think it's a very interesting combination. I'm tasting this for the first time. The restaurant is busy. I think every table is taken. There are people all around. There are people on top of me. I think there's some people right behind me. There are people waiting for the table. There are servers who are watching what's happening. The service here is quite quick. It's the sort of place that you come in, you have your meal and you leave. So the service is tuned around that. Don't expect any frills or thrills. Just come in here to eat some hearty North Karnataka meal, and that's what you will get. That's the experience that you will get. Next with some shenga chutney or that peanut chutney. You taste a toasty bite of the peanuts in this. I love the nutty flavor of the peanut. Mix it with the butter, bring it all together using that Jolada Rotti as somewhat of a mop. I love that buttery goodness and that crunchy, toasty bite of the peanuts. The peanut chutney is also a lot spicier, so you can definitely feel it on your throat. Then we'll taste some of this dal next. It's a thick, hearty dal that's been fortified with some methi or fresh fenugreek. You can taste the dry spices in that bite. What I love about the Jolada Rotti, it makes for such a great accompaniment to any of these dishes. The Jolada Rotti here has no other role to play than carry the flavors of all these dishes within its dry folds to your palate. Go over some of the sprouted mung beans now, or the madike kalu as they call it here. The sprouted mung beans have been cooked just perfectly. They almost snap to the bite, and then you also have the peanuts. You have some of the peanuts here, the shenga, that further adds to the flavor of this dry preparation. Some fiber in. Of course, there's plenty of fiber here, but get more fiber in. I couldn't resist tasting another one of these Jolada Rotti. This roti is light. It's light, it's almost translucent. You can see the light pass through this roti. Get some more of that butter and taste some more of that shenga chutney. I love that shenga chutney. I think it makes for such a spirited bite in between tasting all the other dishes. Ooh, that's delicious. I've almost forgotten this gram flour chutney here. That kadle vele chutney, you can definitely taste the starchiness of the gram flour in that. I think what you can do here with the chutneys is take some of that vegetable, and if you feel you need to add a little more flavor, take some of that butter and take some of that chutney, because the chutneys bring about that flavor spike.
Chili chutney, red chili chutney.
Spicy chutney, the chili chutney. And I'm told you got to eat that with the butter. This chutney is made of Biadgi chili, just by itself first. It's spicy but not overwhelmingly so. Definitely not. I think I'm going to mix some of the butter into that chutney and scoop it up with this Jolada Rotti. I love these chutneys. Each one of the chutneys has its own flavor, has its own character that it brings to the meal. Depending on how spicy you like to devour your North Karnataka meal, you can mix and match these along with your Jolada Rotti and the other vegetables that you have on your leaf. I think I'm going to give a break to my Jolada Rotti and go for some of that Biranji that I see here. This is a Rani Bengaluru special, I'm told, served only on a Thursday. I'm going to take one of that toasted cashew. You can definitely smell the aromas of the cloves that's gone into it, perhaps some cardamom too, and the garlic. In fact, there's plenty of garlic in this biranji. There's slivers of lightly toasted garlic in the rice. The spices are reminiscent of a pulao, but then the lightly toasted garlic cloves take it in a different direction altogether. So the biranji is what happens when a mildly scented pulao meets the robust flavors of North Karnataka, and that results in the biranji. Just wanted to taste some hot gravy of that bandekai. I'm told the bandekai gravy is a combination to the biranji. So on the biranji, you also see these black specks. This, I'm told, is a biranji powder. Take some of that gravy and mix that into the biranji. Oh, this gravy is nice and hot. The flavor of the bandekai takes over the flavor of the biranji completely. What the biranji brings to that mouthful is its layered, subtle flavors. But other than that, it's the robust spicing of this bandekai that you taste all the way. Ghee makes everything delicious.
Sambar.
Sambar. In sambar, isn't
it? Tarkari sambar.
Tarkari sambar. Mulangi, there.
Mulangi.
I got some garlic in that sambar. So there's plenty of garlic that's also used in the cuisine of North Karnataka. They said it's the garlic that gives it all that flavor. And that garlic is quite apparent. This sambar is nice and hot. Get some of that rice and sambar together. That makes for a tasty mouthful. I think what you need also with this is some of that papad made with urad dal. get some of that papad into the rice and the sambar. That is just so delicious. And if you like to spice things up a bit, there's also some pickle here. As I'm told, it's a mixed pickle. I think that's a lemon piece there. So you can take some of that pickle, mix it nicely into that sambar. Get some of the papad, the appala, the uddina appala, and make a crunchy mouthful of it. You know, raw onion is such an underrated accompaniment to food. I think people hesitate from consuming raw onion just by itself for obvious reasons, but it makes us a tasty, hearty accompaniment to food with its ability to liven up anything that's on your palate. And now to close my meal with some musur or curd. Teeny weeny bit of the salt. I'm going to get some of that delicious pickle as well into this curd rice. After tasting all those robust flavors, you also want your curd rice to have some of those zesty, spicy flavors. That curd is thick and creamy, but we still have our kalde vele paisa to taste. You can definitely taste the cardamom in it, that mellow sweetness of the jaggery, and the bite of that chana dal. Beda, sweet beda to close your meal here. So this pan will round up what's been a delicious meal here at Hotel Nalapaka. I think what I really appreciate about the food that I've tasted is the home-style flavor. Also, after speaking to Kavitha Lingayya and finding out her journey where she began this enterprise 20 years ago as a small catering enterprise that has then grown over the years. What's also interesting here is the fact that there's a lot of importance that's given to provenance, given to the ingredients. Most of the ingredients are sourced from North Karnataka, and even the people who cook the food, the ladies that we saw in the kitchen who come from North Karnataka singing all those beautiful folk songs as they prepare the Jolada Rotti. And that truly adds a certain special flavor to the food here at Hotel Nalapaka. So if you're looking to savor a slice of North Karnataka in its delightful culinary traditions, definitely find your way to Hotel Nalapaka here in Rajajinagar in Nama, Bengaluru. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
At Food Lovers TV, my team and I work hard to produce engaging food and travel videos. If you like our work, do check out our Patreon page where you can pledge a nominal sum in lieu of special privileges like behind the scenes footage, early video release, exclusive Q&As, merch and much more. For more info, check out the link in the description below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe, share, like and leave a comment here. Happy eating!